Hello everyone, I am Gagandeep Singh. Welcome to my channel. Today I'll be guiding you through the process of creating a scripted pipeline in Jenkins. This Jenkins CI/CD pipeline will consist of multiple stages, that is, running the test cases, creating a Jacobo static analysis report, publishing code quality analysis in SonarQube, creating a jar or var file and publishing to Nexus repository, and finally deploying the code in Tomcat server. Additionally, an email integration is also provided so that if the build fails, the developer will receive an email with the build name along with the logs. Make sure you already have Jenkins, SonarQube, Tomcat, and Nexus repository installed. Let's begin with setting up all the services, beginning with SonarQube. I'll start my SonarQube. It's available at port 9000. Here we are required to generate an API key. Go to administration section, click on security, users, click on this token, give any name to the token, generate. Copy this token and I'll copy this to a text file. Along with that, you also have to remember the username and password of your SonarQube. By default, for all the services, my credentials will be admin and password will be 123456. Let's move on towards setting up Nexus repository. The default port number is 8081 and your URL would be localhost. Here we have to create a new repository. First, let's sign in. My username and password is admin123456. Now go to settings, click on repositories, click on create repository. Click on Maven 2 hosted, give any name, I'll give pipeline demo, select the version policy as mixed and deploy policy as allow redeploy, create repository. The name is pipeline demo, I'll copy it somewhere, repo name. Here we can see the name, so it's successfully been created. Let's set up our Tomcat server now. First, go to Tomcat conf Tomcat users. Here you have to provide the username and password. Here the username is deployer and these two roles are provided to allow us to access the GUI. Along with that, our Jenkins script to make changes to the Tomcat server. After this, start the Tomcat server. My Tomcat server is running at port 8085. We have now set up all the necessary services. Let's move on towards installing the necessary extensions. Go to Manage Jenkins, Manage Plugins. I already have all the plugins installed, so I will simply name the plugins required. First, we need the file system SCM plugin because we won't be using Git. Second, we need SonarQube plugin that allows Sonar integration. Then we need Jacoco plugin for Jacoco code coverage. Then we need Nexus platform plugin to allow publishing to Nexus. Then we need email extension plugin to allow email integration. And finally, we need deploy to container plugin that allows us to deploy our var file in Tomcat. Make sure you install all these plugins. Now that we have configured our plugins, let's move on towards settings and see everything is properly configured. Go to Manage Jenkins, go to Global Tools Configuration. Scroll down. Here you have SonarQube Scanner. Give any name to it. I have given auto install. Make sure auto install automatically is ticked. And the latest version in SonarQube Scanner dropdown is selected. After that, scroll down, click on Maven installation. Make sure you install Maven. Either you can install automatically or give your path manually. Click on Save. Let's configure the remaining settings. Go to Manage Jenkins, Configure System. Let's make sure everything is configured properly here. Scroll down. First, you will find System Admin email address. This will be the email address through which the email will be sent if a build fails. Moving on towards Nexus. Here, we have to give any display name and then give any server ID. After that, specify the URL where the instance is running. It would be localhost 8081 for you. After that, click on Add button to add the credential. Specify the kind as username and password. Enter the username as admin, password as 123456, and ID as you can give any identifiable name. And after that, select this newly added configuration in this drop-down. I have already done this before, so I won't be doing it. You can test whether it's working properly or not by clicking on Test Connection. Let's move on towards extended email notification configuration. For this, we are required to have an email server. We can use any third-party service for this. I am using SendGrid. After registering, you will be provided with all the configuration in the website. The default port number is usually 25, and this is the SMTP server URL. Click on Advanced. Specify the username and the password provided in the email service. Here we have to specify the default email suffix. You can leave this empty if you want, and all the rest can be empty. We also have to enter the same details in this email notification section. Here, the SMTP server name will be the same as before. We have to provide a default email suffix. Click on Advanced. Specify the SMTP authentication username as well as the password, same as we specified before. And then uncheck SSL. Click on TLS. Specify the port number, and the rest can be empty. The URL for some of the third-party email services that I have used before are provided in the description below. You can try any of them as they are all working with Jenkins properly. Now we have properly configured all our settings. There is one last step remaining before we start working on the actual pipeline, that is making necessary changes in our pom.xml. First, we have to add this packaging var line in our pom.xml. This makes sure that the application creates var file on running MVN package, as Tomcat only supports var files. Now scroll down to the plugin section. Here you have to add Jacoco plugin to ensure a Jacoco code coverage report is created. After that, Sonar plugin for the Sonar code quality coverage report to be published. This snippet is available in the description below. Now that we are done with all configuration and setting up, let's implement the pipeline. Click on New Item. Give any name. Click on Pipeline. OK. Now scroll down and copy and paste this pipeline script code. I have already created this and I will once walk you through this code. So this is a Jenkins scripted pipeline with multiple steps. The first step is checkout, where I am copying my code from my source code directory to Jenkins workspace. The next step is package step. This will run, compile, test, and then create a var file of our application. And then we have test and Jacoco static analysis report. This will create a JUnit report and publish it in Jenkins. And then we have Jacoco that will create a code coverage report of our application. Next step is Sonar scanner coverage. This will publish code quality analysis in Sonar Cube Scanner. First, we have to specify the API key that we created initially. This one. This is the API key you have to replace from this. And then we have to specify the host URL where the Sonar scanner is running. Next step is publish to Nexus. This step will publish our var file in Nexus repository. First, we have to specify the Nexus ID that we have created in our settings, and then the repository. This is the name of the repository we have created in Nexus. And then in file path, we have to give a path to the var file. This can be a relative path or an absolute path. Here I am giving the relative path. And then the artifact ID and the group ID. Preferably, it must be the same as the one in pom.xml, but it's not compulsion. And then I'm specifying the packaging, which is var. Next step is to deploy our source code in Tomcat server. Here we have to specify the credential ID that is associated with Tomcat username and password. Then we have to give the URL of our Tomcat server. Here we have to give the path to our var file. Here I have given the wildcard path to my var file. Finally, all these steps are enclosed in try catch block so that if any of the step fails, then catch block will be executed and an email will be triggered. To refers to the email ID to which the mail will be sent. Then I am setting the current build status as failure. This is the variable for subject and content refers to the logs of the build failed. And finally, I am sending this email. This was the short explanation of this pipeline script. Now let's run this pipeline script. Click on Save. Build now. To save time, I have skipped the build part of this video. After successful build, you will get this message, finished success. Now let's cross-verify in all the services whether this project was created or not. Let's go back and see our Jacoco and JUnit report. Over here, we can see test result trend and code coverage trend. Now let's go to Sonar Cube. 192.9000. Here we can see this last analysis 3 minutes ago. Now let's move on towards Nexus. 192. Pipeline demo. Here we can see our repository. Now let's finally check our deployed code in Tomcat server. Manage app, gift shop API, true. Now let's see whether it's running or not. I will access one of my endpoints. PROD UCTS. Okay, so it's working properly. In this way, we can implement a CI/CD pipeline for Java code in Jenkins. All the necessary snippets and information are available in the description below. If you have any doubts or you are facing any issues, you can post them in the comments below. Thank you for watching the video.